Hello, I am back safe and sound after a long evening out. I went to my Mozart, well, technically there was some Mozart music, but it was at the Mirabell Palace, which is where Mozart used to play. And it was wonderful, great show. I met a couple, I think I mentioned it in the last video, so I won't go into it, but they were great. And then I went looking for something to eat after the concert. And there was this group of Germans who I met earlier in the day when I was just walking through my hotel lobby. And super nice, big group of guys. And they said, "We'll see you in town. It's a small town, Salzburg." And I thought, "Ha, what are the chances? Small town." So I go to this concert. And then I'm looking for something to eat after the concerts, like a little before 10. And I'm walking through the main part of town where the bars, restaurants, shops, and everything are. And what do you know? Sitting at the corner table of a place on a patio right there are those same guys. So, got some food there, sat and chatted with them. Ended up running into, just chatting with people around the table, and the waitress recommended a place that had music. So we went and sat there. I met this really sweet lady named Birgit. Super, super nice. And they were playing tons of music, and it was very, very loud. And it was a super good time. I met a bunch of really wonderful people. So far, Austria has been amazing. And I really like it here. It's beautiful. It looks just like Switzerland. According to the Austrians that I've met, though, the cost of living is not Switzerland style cost of living, so that's nice. But it is incredibly beautiful, and everybody is very nice. So it was a good day all around. Made it through the three tours. Well, tours. Technically, one tour, a cooking class, and a concert, and it was a great day. All right, I was gonna take a nap, but the pharmacy is closed tomorrow and it closes at 6 today, and I'm desperate for some ibuprofen. My shoulder's still killing me from swimming, and somehow, being an old lady, I managed to hurt somewhere in my scapular area. Just taking off my jacket this morning, so that's called being old, and you fall apart with no effort. So I need to find some ibuprofen, and now that I'm out and about, I just see beautiful things that I want to check out in every direction, so maybe I'll wander about for a while. Okay, I totally need to take this boat ride. Super fun. Alright, so that's the bridge that Sound of Music kids and Maria skip over when they're in their picnic clothes. Beautiful horses. Incredible fountain. Salzburg. Okay. Now I'm going to climb up to that fortress. Alright. I don't know what that giant gold ball symbolizes. The man standing on top of it. It looks pretty cool. Okay, how cool is this? Big old fortress. Climbing up there. Look how pretty this fountain is. A big old pool here. This city is stunning. It's very similar to Switzerland. I wonder if the cost of living is less. Could I live in Austria? Kinda like Germans better than the French. Okay, so I didn't take any pictures in there, but it was really cool. So the armory, most of the time, just a big old room with a bunch of old looking weapons and not very fun. people here have developed a really interesting way to make it more fun. They have interactive games. They have computer things that generate a custom-made suit of armor that you can take a picture of yourself wearing. Anyways, really cool. Lots of kids in there playing. It's made it a lot more interesting than many of the other castles that I've gone into. At the top of the fortress here in Salzburg. So beautiful. View of the river from up above. The city is just gorgeous, and today's weather is absolutely perfect. Really cool windows on the side of this fortress. You can actually get behind them and see all about how beautiful this place is.
Alright, I was running out of time to walk back down. My ticket entrance to the fortress included the funicular back down. Oh my gosh, it's moving a lot faster than I anticipated. Holy bananas. This is the angle of the same square, but from the other side, after going up to the fortress. Gosh, this city is just beautiful. And there's super clean public restrooms with toilet seats and toilet paper. Sorry to harp on this, but that's a big deal after 18 days in Italy. All right, so my adventure to the fortress, I initially just left to go to the pharmacy, but of course, turned into an adventure to the fortress, because you know me, can never pass up some walking. So here I am, and it's a little hot and sweaty, and I thought, oh, I'd love to stop for a beer, but I don't really have time. I have to leave for the concert in an hour, and I'm kind of grungy for a concert. But great news, my hotel has a bar, and they just charged my room, and they just gave me a beer to take back to my room while I get ready. How awesome is that? All right, so I'm heading to the concert at the Mirabell Palace, and all cleaned up and spiffy, so ready to go, looking forward to it. This is a whole new world. People who actually follow the crosswalk signals, even when there's no cars coming, they're not jaywalking. This is some crazy schniz after 18 days in Berlin. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty in here. Fancy statues, beautiful ceiling. I'm going to a concert where Mozart used to play. This is going to be amazing. Oh my gosh, this is beautiful. Beautiful venue for a concert. All right, my friends, the concert was amazing. It was so beautiful. The musicians, they had such a passion for what they were doing, and it just came forth. You could see them smiling at each other as they were interacting. It was absolutely just amazing to watch. And the venue was just beautiful. What an experience. It was so great. During the intermission, I met a really sweet couple, Albert and Crystal from Fort Lauderdale. And they're just really sweet. We talked for a little bit, had a drink at intermission, and then when the concert was over, we just kind of chatted for a few more minutes. Albert's family and him
are from Belgium, and so he put in a whole bunch of restaurant recommendations and things to see when I'm in Brussels, so I'm really excited about that, and we'll see. No pressure. They did ask what I was up to tomorrow after my tour, and I said I had no plans. And they said, okay, well, maybe we'll message you on WhatsApp and see about doing dinner. So I don't know what'll work out. And that's what's so wonderful about this trip is I never know what's gonna work out. And I just go with the flow and enjoy who I meet and where I go. So if I see them, then it's meant to be. If not, it was wonderful to meet them this evening. Just another great night.